Alright, welcome back. It's me. Go ahead and continue on from where we left off. This is, I'll go ahead and just say my name's Gunny Boy.
Just simply put.
And we're continuing on off from where we left off last time. Last time we got to level 3 from level 1. And we just picked up a quest of to report to Executor Aaron in Death Knell. And so we're going to go ahead and report to him real quick as everyone else is starting off. It seems to be the rush hour of traffic.
I am forsaken.
Hopefully I can get out of here before it starts to get really bad. One thing I'd like to do first is I would like to do the Wakening before I move on. Typically when you do quests and you first pick up a quest and you don't do it, it'll go from red to orange to yellow to green, and then it can go to gray. If it goes to gray, that means you cannot get any experience and you get very little money from it. So it all in all, it just sucks. So if you can get a yellow quest or even a red quest, interestingly enough, and finish those, you can actually get more experience that way than typically just doing a standard and doing the quest and then going through all this killing and whatnot and then realize, oh, I have this quest I have to finish. And yeah, it doesn't work well doing it that way. It's a lot harder to do it that way, and it's also just, all in all, it's a pain in the butt, and you do more killing than really what's really worth it. And so it's like, oh well, yeah, it's just not worth it. And it's not worth it. And as you see, I learned Eviscerate. And it'll pop up with tips and whatnot. One thing about rogues, unlike other magic users and whatnot, is rogues use combo points. Combo points build up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 combo points in a combination of each. Combo points will show up on the side there. Every combo point that you get on a target typically can stack. And for stuff like Eviscerate, as I go over to here, P brings up your spellbook, scenario abilities. And Eviscerate, when you get up to 5 points, you can do instant damage of 69 damage. Now that's at level 1. That's just a standard level 1 finishing move. As things progress, and what I may end up doing is I will probably show a number of different things on here as far as the different kinds of rogue, types of rogues that you can get. Types of rogues actually are variant onto your talent points. And talent points can actually affect how your abilities work. Rogues have 3 different trees that you can go into later on after you go into level 40. That is great. After you go to level 40, you can get what's called dual talent specialization. What that allows you to do is that allows you to have 2 individual trees that you are majored in and just be able to switch between them. It's very expensive though. Or it can be. And instead of having to reset your talent tree all the time, you just simply go ahead and you simply just switch trees. But you can only specialize in just 2. You can't do all 3. As you'll probably recognize, is I will use a combination of different things. I'm very familiar with a rogue, so it's one of those things where I know how to use them. along with mages, priests, and of course death knights. You will see a combination of different abilities and different things that other characters will do. I will have other people on other characters on here, friends of mine that I will have here, that they will be helping me out, and they'll be working with me as far as quests go and as far as dungeons go. Dungeons are one of the most hardest things to do, just simply because you can't do it on your own. It requires a party of five or more. Sometimes it requires a raid group, which is a total of more than five people. And it's just a matter of, okay, well, you gotta be able to work with these people in order to accomplish your goal, which is whatever the quest that's in the dungeon is. Now, the animals that I'll be working with right now, they're your low-end, not-so-powerful animals. The other ones here, however, the ones that we'll be facing in the future, are completely different. They will have abilities. They will have very nasty DOTs or damage over times, or they'll have they can do Sunder Armor, Thunderclap. They can do all these different abilities that can really mess you up if you get caught in it. I will actually be in the heat of most of the action. If you're a mage, you're going to be standing back. If you are a priest, you're going to be way the heck back, just simply because you don't want to be in the midst of you don't want to be in the action. Right now, I'm actually looking for these two people. I believe they are over here. I could be wrong. I have been wrong before, so if you see me do something wrong, or if you see an alternate way of doing a quest or a dungeon, let me know. That way I can either comment on it, or I can improve the way that my party will be functioning. There she is. Or he. And so I'm going to try and keep these keep these within 5 minutes. This is a priest using smite, apparently. Priest abilities, they start off with one, which is smite, and they work your way up. Hunters are, which is kind of strange because I've never seen a undead hunter before. Yep, undead hunters are not common. I will also be not just working on this character, I will also have another one that I will have, which will be a hunter. I enjoy the hunter just simply because they're very easy to use. They're very simple to use, and they're very easy to use. But it's not going to be an undead. Undead hunters are not very effective. They're very resistant on a lot of different scales, but I do enjoy helping out people. And so, yes, every once in a while you'll see me help someone out. It does not take much for me to help people out. Some people who do get on, they're not quite familiar with the game. So that's really the reason that I'm doing this video, is to help some people out and help them figure out, this is how I do this and that, as I'm trying to figure out where that other person is. the typically what a lot of people like to do, like I said, this game can get sophisticated in many different ways by putting add-ons and damage meters and all these other little factors. I don't do all that. I don't change the interface too much, just simply because it can get hectic. And yeah, Lillian Voss should be around here. There she is.
Death. What will you require?
Yeah.
Dark lady watch over you.
You're lying, my father won't protect me. And then she dies. You actually find her, Lillian Voss, you actually find her later on in the game. A lot of characters you will find later on in the game. If you've watched the my test video, there's a goblin there that actually appears later on. And, oh, hello. Darnell is another person. You actually do see him later on in the game, too. He becomes mayor or something like that. But he's a warrior. And so Darnell is an all-familiar figure. I don't remember exactly his whole step-by-step process and all that. But he does, we do travel with him and whatnot. So it's kind of interesting how some of these characters, they actually develop with you. And so it's as it progresses, and it's interesting how they tie the game in itself with you yourself as the character within the game. So it's an interesting feature. There's one. So we're gonna go around and we're going to kick some bodies, apparently. And like I've said before, they've made this game easier and easier. He's gonna kick the body and put it on top. This is gonna get interesting. Because you can actually stack these bodies up pretty high. And it's funny watching him do this. As you can see, he already looks like a friggin' mountain of corpses. It's just interesting to watch some of the things that they do. You can go very far, and as far as the dealio goes with a lot of these. And let's see here, can we get the other one? Yeah, we can. We can get that one though. So, like I said, you see a whole pile of bodies on here, and it can get actually quite humorous. The game can be. So this is just one of those things where it's like, okay, and you take the pile of bodies over to Sultan.
What now?
It will be quite interesting to see how a lot of this unfolds, because they weren't living to begin with, so it's funny how some of this will actually come to be. Now, interestingly enough, press B, that'll equip your, that'll pull up your inventory. I need to start putting on some armor, because if I don't, I will die. This is your, basically your character armor stuff thing. And you've got your weapons, you've got your rings and trinkets, you've got wrists, you've got, which I should actually have, there are things here. You've got fox gloves, you've got You've got a whole number of different things that you can equip. I will be, since I am based in leather, that is something that I will actually be wearing quite a bit of. And you will see the character will change a bit, as you can already see. She will, as I was saying before, there's different professions that you can actually do, and each profession allows you to do different, they increase different skills. I will probably end up picking up skinning for her, which increases your critical strike rating.
Hello.
So,
remember, patience.
I don't remember what I need. Oh, I know what I need to do. Basically, with this quest, each character has their own set of character quests. Pretty much, what they have you do is they have you pretty much exercise different abilities. And this particular one, you have to get up to level 5. And that sucked. And pretty much from there, you have to, unless they changed it, which allows me to use it on... Nope, they changed it. It used to be that you had to get up to level 5, up to the number 5 of this grade. And then from there, do your thing, like what I just did. Now you can do it. You can stab them once with this, which is Sinister Strike, and then do your thing from there. So, yeah, level 5 is going to be stealth, and that is all you can learn in the starter zone. This area here, which is Death Now, this is the starter zone for those Horde players. If you're Alliance and you come over here and you start, you know, killing all the guards and all that stuff, that's all fine and dandy, but that attracts a lot of attention. I have done that myself. I've gone over to starter zones in other places, like, what's that place? Down in the Dwarven area. Down around Ironforge. And, yeah, you'll have actual buffed up PvP players that will come in there and they will kill you. They will destroy you. And, regardless of what you're wearing, they will kill you. It's just a matter of, okay, well, we have these people, and they usually never travel by themselves. Some will just stand there and watch you, and they're not watching you. They're actually talking to their friends and saying, hey, let's gank this person and take them out. And so, yeah, it's not a good idea. Typically, when you have level 20 people just staring at you there, they're usually talking to a guild, and they're going to bite you. And there's no way to get rid of them unless you just simply walk away. Like I said, it attracts way too much attention going to starting zones and killing a bunch of guards and quest givers and stuff. It's not worth it. I have done that many times, and you do die. You may kill a few people, a few other players while along the way, but all in all, it's not worth it. Because you end up getting your armor broken, and you cannot... you have to repair it, and you don't have any money to... You run out of money. Unless you're drop dead rich, or you spend money to get money. Which is kind of dumb in my eyes. These guys, Nightweb Spiders. These guys used to be... They used to be hostile. I believe they stopped being hostile when they did the second expansion. This quest in itself used to be a pain. Simply put, because these things you have one, but you have another that's not far off. And if you're not careful, you usually would attract not just one, but two, like these two. If I was a rogue, I couldn't just go up and attack that one, that guy. I'd have to do what's called knife throwing, which I need to pull out. Throw. I'll put you right there. Typically, when you do throw is a ranged, skill. You cannot use it up close. It won't let you. So rogues, they will. If you ever see them do deadly throw, that means they're far away. That means they're a good distance, and they know that they can get killed by the person who is through their attack. Or they have a. There's a certain skill that actually ties into it. You also can use it to tag other different enemies, like quests and whatnot, if you want to try and tag it before someone else gets it. Like, for example, if he was going after this guy, or if he was coming in to attack him, I could easily throw the knife, and that would tag him to me. It can be inconsiderate, but sometimes it's necessary, just simply because of the difficulty in trying to do the quest, and sometimes it can be inconsiderate, but sometimes it is necessary. I've done it. Other people have done it to me. You think they're Bamas, you know, a-holes, all that stuff, but in the end, it's just a game, and it's just not. Sometimes it's not worth it. And, yeah. Now, if you're a rogue and you do decide to stick with a rogue, stick with throwing, you can't use guns, and you can't use a number of other different things in this game, and so yeah, it does suck after a while. So you'd have great abilities and whatnot with it, but in the end, you wouldn't be able to use other weapons effectively enough to actually do something. I'm going to go ahead and finish this quest up, and then I'm going to take another break, and we'll get back to this as soon as we can. So, I got one more. Oh no, I'm already done. I'm going to go ahead and turn the quest in, return to town. That will be it for starting off, and we'll take a short break and get back to it. And there's the town. Get up to the corner here, and that will be it. As you started to notice, I'm level 4. Last time I got to level 3, and it's progressively gotten slower. As the level progresses, it will probably end up staying like that. You'll notice that I'll probably end up getting, it'll progressively get slower as things progress. And so as she gets higher level, the quests, I'm not going to level as much. Leveling will start to slow down. Like I said, leveling typically, it seems really fast up until about 12 to 15 around in there. That's really all there is to it. So I will take a short break and we will come back to this. All right, this is Gunny Boy. Bye.